Good morning and welcome to Our Lady of Victories and to the Mass of Anointing of the Sick. At this time, if you haven't already done so, please silence your cell phones. Today, our presider is Father Wojciech. Concelebrating is Father Ed and Father Sam. Our gathering song this morning is Here I Am, Lord, number 395. Please stand and join in singing.
Sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord. Amen.
River of glory, springs of our
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
We'll now sing the glory. God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Observing the boldness of Peter and John, and perceiving them to be uneducated, ordinary men, the leaders, elders, and scribes were amazed, and they recognized them as the companions of Jesus. Then when they saw the man who had been cured standing there with them, they could say nothing in reply. So they ordered them to leave the Sanhedrin and conferred with one another, saying, "What are we to do with these men? Everyone living in Jerusalem knows that a remarkable sign was done through them, and we cannot deny it. But so that it may not spread any further among the people, let us give them a stern warning, never again to speak to anyone in this name." So they called them back and ordered them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. Peter and John, however, said to them in reply, "Whether it is right in the sight of God for us to obey you rather than God, you be the judges. It is impossible for us not to speak about what we have seen and heard." After threatening them further, they released them, finding no way to punish them, on account of the people who were all praising God for what had happened.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Mark. When Jesus had risen early on the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had driven seven demons. She went and told his companions, who were mourning and weeping. When they heard that he was alive and had been seen by her, they did not believe her. After this, he appeared in another form to two of them, walking along their way to the countryside. They returned and told the others, but they did not believe them either.
But later, as the 11 were at table, he appeared to them and rebuked them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they did not believe those who saw him after he had been raised. He said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature." The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We wanted to do this Mass now in the Easter season so that it is also a joyful season for us, and it can help us in our different trials and difficulties and sufferings. This Mass that is together with the anointing of the sick, and there are the two sacraments that we will, most of you will receive today, which is to strengthen us in our sufferings. And on the other hand, Jesus is going to also nourish us with his body. It's very powerful, the two sacraments together. We are celebrating now Easter, the resurrection of Christ. Christ so many times wanted to emphasize, I was very impressed this week, celebrating Masses different days of the week, how much Christ emphasized the resurrection of the body. You know how much we suffer in the body, in flesh. Not only because of physical sufferings, but also, you know, when you have a suffering because of your child, you suffer in your flesh, not only in spirit. It's very interesting, this image. You know, we suffer in flesh. How many consequences of the sins of the flesh make us produce sufferings? It would be very interesting to make a long reflection on it. And this is why Christ emphasized so much the resurrection of the body. Not only that he has risen, you know, that he is now, but not only the spirit and the soul, it's not just the ghost, but it's the body. To give us a lot of hope that our body will one day also rise. No, I look at Diane here in the wheelchair, and you know, I have a saying for ascension, I like to say it, for the ascension, in heaven there are no wheelchairs. Then I see the lady here with the cane, no cane. I see Jim on a wheelchair in the back, no wheelchairs in heaven, Jim. Do you hear me well? If we go to heaven, no wheelchairs. And what is the most powerful about this Mass is that the Lord gives us, and he will give it for sure today. This is why John Paul II wanted to introduce the World Day of the Sick on the memorial of Our Lady of Lourdes, because the biggest and the most important miracle is not a physical miracle, but a moral miracle. And this is why we hear also in the first reading of today, you know, John and Peter one day find themselves in front of the beautiful gate, and then there is a crippled man. And he is so diminished, the suffering diminished him to keep begging for some alms. And sometimes, you know, the suffering, the pain, can make us so relative. Everything becomes useless, you know. I have seen and spoke to people, when the suffering takes over our lives, many times people say, "I am useless. I don't need to live. Why am I still around?" You know, everything loses taste and meaning. And so this man was diminished to beg alms, just to beg, "Give me some love, give me some money, give me some coins." And John and Peter came to him and said, "We don't have silver or gold, but what we have, we'll give you." And since they have experience of the risen Lord and they are sharing it, they said, "In the name of the risen Lord, of Jesus, rise and walk." They gave him a resurrection, and the resurrection made him walk and rise. And it's very powerful, because as far as we are risen in our soul, the suffering cannot crush us. That is the beauty of it. No suffering can crush us as far as we are, have a resurrection or the risen Lord inside. And this is the power that these men have experienced. And this is why they go around and they preach, for which they want to tell them, shut up, don't say things about resurrection. And we say, we cannot. Also in the gospel, it's very beautiful to see how Mary Magdalene, this gospel of today, this is the gospel of the octave of Saturday, of Easter today, starts when Jesus has risen early on the first day of the week. He appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had driven seven demons. Imagine how sick was Mary Magdalene. You think you are sick? She was sick. She was with seven demons. Because if I am sick in the body, but I am healthy in my soul, I can go to the Lord, I am in grace, I have a strength. Instead, if I am sick in my soul, it's much, much worse. And the gospel says the Lord has taken out of her seven demons, seven very serious sicknesses, mortal sicknesses, much worse than a physical sickness that leads to death. Because a moral sickness could lead to eternal death, which is much worse. And this is the first woman he meets. It's very powerful, this image also, that he meets Mary Magdalene, the one that was so sinful, and this is the one to whom Jesus wants to appear, risen. And as I said before, he emphasizes so much the resurrection of the body. You know, the very first thing that he shows to the disciples are the wounds, which if we were to enter into a very theological discussion, Jesus risen and glorious should not have wounds. Because when we will rise, our body will be risen, we will not have wounds, will not keep our scars from this life. And yet Jesus decided to keep his wounds. He wanted the scars to be like trophies, trophies of the resurrection, and to show that he is not ashamed. And this is why I wanted to say this very important detail. Brothers and sisters, do not be ashamed of the fact that you are sick. Don't be ashamed that you are going through a trial. St. Paul one day says in the letter to the Colossians something very powerful. He's so bold. He says, I rejoice in my sufferings because through my sufferings I complete to what is lacking in the sufferings of Christ. It's powerful to say something like that. Which means he's participating through his sufferings also as Christ was participating through his sufferings on the cross, redeeming the humanity. And this is what John Paul II speaks in his encyclical Salvifici Doloris about the meaning of suffering. He speaks about the redeeming meaning of suffering. Because if I just suffer to suffer, it doesn't make sense. But if there is a meaning, if I offer it for somebody, or then this suffering has a meaning. And also for us, it brings us closer to the Lord. How many times physically I suffered, it brought me closer to the Lord. It is also, a trial in which we can see how God is close to us. I'm sure many of you who are very sick have an experience of a very closeness, of a great closeness of the Lord in his sacraments, in his love. Also maybe when the priest visits you, it's, you know, we feel so close. It's a moment in which it's a paradox. It's a moment in which we feel very lonely on one hand, and on the other hand, we feel like the Lord is everything. It's as powerful as this. And that's why I wanted to thank you for your, because it's a witness. It's not an easy witness. It's Jesus is on the cross, you are on the wheelchair. Or no, you saw this young lady who was reading. I don't want to say all the details, but she's pregnant. She's here not only to take, she's taking care of Diane, but she also is going through a very difficult pregnancy. Pray for her also. I told her we pray at this Mass for her. So we all go through different, and I am sure this is not to make her higher than anybody. Everybody goes through different trials, but this is why it's beautiful to be together, because we are like a team, no? One is injured, the others fight and cheer and pray for them, right? Tomorrow I am sick, you pray for me. Like this we go. And we say, and don't be deceived by one thing. Just because you cannot walk anymore well, or because we are on a wheelchair, doesn't mean that you are worse than others. I am more worried about people who I see super healthy every day, and maybe they are super sick. At least you, I know that you are sick, and I pray and all this, but some people I see super healthy, and maybe they are very sick, and I don't even know. You know what I mean, right? Sick in the soul. There is this word, Day of the Sick this year, was titled with the words from the Gospel of Luke, take care of him. You remember when the Samaritan is beaten on the road, he's lying down, the man who was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and then there is a Samaritan, there are people who pass by, they don't care, and then there is a Samaritan who takes this man and brings him to the inn and says to the owner of the inn, take care of him. So I wanted to thank also all those who are caregivers here. No, Jim was saying his brother is his caregiver in the back. Then we care for each other in so many different ways. So I see Christine, the daughter, is taking care of the mom. Is that your mom? Also, yes, Marisa. And like this. Also, I wanted to thank St. Vincent de Paul Society, our ladies who are also today's caregivers, you know, in so many different ways. Like this, we help each other. Take care of him, it was saying, until I come, and now if I need to pay more, I will pay more, he says, to the owner of the inn. This is how we take care also of each other. So as we celebrate now this Eucharist, we will pass now to the anointing of the sick, the first part, on which we'll lay the hand, that we'll pray first, and we'll lay our hands on you, on those who need, and then after we'll anoint you on the forehead, because here is like, we could say, we suffer the most here. If you are well here, you are well everywhere. You know, because here are all the thoughts when you have to go to the doctor, oh my gosh, you have a cancer, oh my gosh, this, oh my gosh, this, and all kind of crazy, you know, St. Teresa of Avila used to say, the crazy of the house. It keeps going and we need the grace of the Lord to keep it calm, to say, shut up, I don't want to listen to you. The Lord knows better what I need, what I have to go through and all this. Maybe my sickness is helping my children to become softer because they are more sick than I am. I don't know. Maybe my sickness is helping my neighbor. I don't know. If we, one day, this will be so beautiful. I hope we'll go to heaven, no? Let us pray for each other that we'll end up in heaven one day. And when we will find out why you were sick, or why this person was sick, wow, this will be like, wow, now I understand. I will just tell you the story if Diane doesn't, any, she doesn't mind. One day, I told, I think, already this, because it was so moving, even for me it was impacting, imagine for many others. I saw her husband, Richie, with her in a restaurant, accompanied by many beautiful young girls. And I say, wow, the guy is good, all these young girls are following him, you know. Either he pays them a lot of money, or what does he do? And then, after a while, I see that he's going with her, with the wheelchair around. And I was so moved. And he was not ashamed, and he was as happy as he was before. And then I found out, you know, they are working for his beauty salon, you know, like the haircut or whatever. But this is the one he really cares the most for. And it was very moving, you know, to see that. And do you think this is not a witness to these young girls? For their own marriage, for their own life, for their own children to be, because if you have a wife like this, just leave her in peace, find somebody else. Do you see that everything can be a witness, and we don't even know how much impact it has around us. That's why let us leave it with faith, let us ask the grace of the Lord. So we'll anoint you on the forehead and then on the hands. It's powerful this today on Easter, that Jesus shows his wounds as trophies, They don't bleed no more, and we will be exactly there. We'll be anointed on our hands also. And then we'll receive the nourishment of the body of Christ for our own body that is weak. What better thing could we get? What a better treatment, what a better chemo or radiation you want. This way is so powerful to receive these sacraments, because we don't see, like you don't see microwave, you don't see radiation of the microwave, but they are powerful. And the radiation we're gonna receive today is a very serious, powerful treatment that will help us to go on. Yeah? So I will now ask you to please stand. Lord our God, thank you for the lives of these sisters and brothers here before you. They have shown us what service and dedication mean, and they remain for us a sign of your fidelity and loving concern. Help them to meet the challenges they face in their continuing pilgrimage that ends in and through you. Hear our prayers, O Lord, and be merciful to us. Take us by the hand and lead us to life today and forever. Let us pray for our brothers and sisters and for all those who devote themselves to caring for them. Bless all here with new hope and strength, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Relieve their pain, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Free them from sin and do not let them give way to temptation, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Sustain all the sick with your power, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Assist all who care for the sick, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Give life and health to our brothers and sisters, on whom we lay our hands in your name. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Signs are important to us in our everyday life. They are just as important in our life with God. The priest now will impose his hands on all of those who to receive the sacrament of the sick, showing the unity of the church, the care and compassion of the entire community, and the strength that Jesus gives when we meet him in this sacrament. Silently we all pray for those who have hands laid upon them. So Monsignor Seikos will start from this side, he will go down, then Father Ed will start from the back, and I will start from here. Those who do not need this sacrament, I will ask you to please be seated at this time. And those who are in need, we will come, impose our hands. The moment you are done, you can also sit down, yeah? Thank you. Let us stand. Praise to you, O God, the Almighty Father, you sent your Son to live among us and bring us salvation. Blessed be God who hears us in Christ. Praise to you, God, the only begotten Son, you humbled yourself to share in our humanity and you heal our infirmities.
Blessed be God who hears us in Christ.
Praise to you, God, the Holy Spirit, the Consoler, your unfailing power gives us strength in our bodily weakness. God of mercy, ease the sufferings and comfort the weakness of your servants whom the Church anoints with this holy oil. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Now those who receive the sacrament are anointed on their foreheads and hands with the oil of the sick, which was blessed by our Archbishop Cardinal Tobin this past Holy Monday. On Holy Monday in the Cathedral of Newark, the oils were blessed. Father Ed just made sure that we have this new oil that we are using, just freshly blessed on Holy Monday for this purpose. So we will pass by again the same way like we did before, and we will anoint you on forehead, and then you can put your hands in this way. We'll anoint you on your hands, and then you can, those who are anointed already, then you can sit down, yeah? Okay?
Thank you.
Let us stand. Father in heaven, through this holy anointing, grant our brothers and sisters comfort in their suffering. When they are afraid, give them courage. When afflicted, give them patience. When dejected, afford them hope. And when alone, assure them of the support of your holy people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Mindful of God's personal love and of his many blessings in our lives, we pray for ourselves and the needs of our community. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. That the Holy Spirit will imbue us with the great truth that suffering and trials are not meaningless but can lead us to salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the church will be rich with apostles, with the people determined to witness Jesus in the face of persecution and hatred. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that we may truly forgive anyone who has caused us pain, knowing that Jesus cannot heal our wounds or our hearts if we are holding any bitterness or grudges in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the sick and suffering, the lonely and oppressed may feel in their hearts that God has not forgotten them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Lord will give us the strength to accept some of the discomforts of old age, and that our youth may learn to love, respect, and serve the aged. We pray to the Lord.
Lord
Jesus Christ, you shared in our human nature to heal the sick and save all mankind. Mercifully listen to our prayers for the spiritual and physical health of our sick sisters and brothers whom we have anointed in your name. May your protection console them and your strength make them well again. Help them find hope in suffering, for you have given them a share in your passion. You are the Lord forever and ever. Amen. So this Mass intention is, please be seated. The Mass intention is offered for all of you who are sick, and also the Rosary Society has offered this Mass also in a special way for Linda Way.
And let us sing together number 439, number 439 for offertory.
Standing on wings at my side.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice and your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of the Holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constant at work within us may be the cause of our ending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. He took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
And the Lord your church spread throughout the world, bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, our local bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. By the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
With the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Grant to us your strength.
Spirit, lead us home into our belonging. Love has made a way, our future is secure. And beyond the veil, all our tears forgotten. Every last affliction we will leave behind. Every shame forgiven as we find our life. And oh, how we shall sing forever in the skies. We are healed in Christ.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. I don't know if Karen, did you show the people here in the church? No, I think it would be good. Can you just turn around for a moment so that people will see who is here otherwise? Karen was recording the mass, so that if you know somebody who is maybe in the family or who didn't come, and they are really like, you know, we cannot transport them, so it will be on our website, and like this, it is always a good way to help somebody, not to see that you are here and all this. There is on our website still, since the pandemic, we are not gonna take it away. There is a special little video with the prayer of the sick, and it helped already, I don't know how many people here away in different countries, people who sometimes they are in the hospitals and maybe nobody can enter, nobody can see them. We ask the nurses to either play it for them so that they could hear it, or if they can see it, even play it so that they can see it. Is a prayer on our website. You can see prayer, video prayer for the sick. It has helped many people already. I just wanted to thank our musicians, Liz and Selena, for making it. Obviously, it's nice to be with them, right? Yeah. Very good. There is behind me a very famous celebrity here. Monsieur Summer Sekus, okay, he came all the way from West Virginia for this Mass of the Anointing. He knew how important you are, and that's why, no, he's helping us, meaning he is on a little vacation, but also helping us, and graciously he is also helping us today. Thank you, Monsieur. Thank you for your presence. I think we'll leave all the other applauses. There is also Karen here, who is helping us always, and then the ladies who helped us from the St. Vincent de Paul Society. We have even the head here of Holy Name Society, so there is a lot of groups. Charlie in the back. Can you raise your hand, Charlie, like this? They know who you are. Holy Name Society for the men. It's very nice. I think Ken is also in that, right? They have every month they meet, they discuss. It's a very, very lively group. Every month they are really lively, and they are growing actually. They are nourishing themselves spiritually through discussion, prayer, and everything. So, and then there are you, no? Father Ed also. You know Father Ed. I think everybody knows Father Ed, our parochial vicar, right? And then the ladies prepared a little refreshments downstairs for us. So if you are able to come down, we ask you, and don't worry about the wheelchair, no wheelchair, there is elevator and all this. You can go all the way down. Like if you go, for example, Laura, there is a with the elevator, you can go all the way down to the, I believe, what is it, the first or what?
One R,
thank you, because I don't use it that much, I don't know. So one R, you go all the way down, and you go, when you come out to the right, and you go to the lower, there is no steps from there. And then going out, you can also use the elevator half measure. And so, because it's a very beautiful moment to be together. If you cannot, I understand. But if you could, stay even for a moment, have a little coffee or something, because just to be together, it's very medicinal, you know? Naturally, by nature, we all tend to isolate, to be independent. You know, we want to do our own little way. Nobody, you know, can tell us and all this, but to be together is very, very, it helps us a lot. It's very medicinal. Many of our sicknesses go away because of being together. You would be surprised. So, and then I wanted to greet all those who will be watching us and seeing us, that your suffering is valuable, and that we pray for you, that we remember you here at Our Lady of Victories, and please pray for us as well. Now, just before the final blessing, I will ask the ladies, just as they all only gonna do maybe a first, only strophe is a little portion. There is this beautiful hymn I was thinking of this in this week, you know, that says, "Do not be afraid, I am with you," you know? Take it as the Lord, it will be obviously, they will be doing it, but take it as if the Lord is speaking to you through these words. Is it okay? Just for a moment of like a kind of communion meditation, and then we'll finish with the final blessing and we go to eat. Yeah? Because through them you show us that there is not only this life, but there is another life, much better, to which we aspire, and that we do not have to worry about all the sufferings and pains, because you are with us. We ask you to bless this food, this companionship that we will share in a moment. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Okay, ladies, we'll attack with the hymn now.
And we will sing, "We Will Rise Again."